TFLN stands for thin film lithium niobate. It comes as a replacement from bulk lithium niobate, which was introduced 10 years ago for the deployment of high capacity fiber optic networks. And thin film lithium niobate introduces major breakthroughs, enabling much higher capacity as well as much lower cost and ease of manufacturing.
We believe that MirrorX is developing a solution that really targets the need, not only for now, also for the next decades. And we believe our young platform, TFLN, could play a major role here.
When we design photonic integrated circuits, we are facing many challenges, especially for quantum applications. Some of the challenges are achieving the lowest transmission losses possible and also the highest electro-optical efficiency through those photonic integrated circuits. So these are the major challenges we have to face. And we've been working really well together to actually speed up the learning process and also the manufacturing process.
When we started this development 4 or 5 years ago, the biggest challenge was that we were first in the domain. And now we are happy that we have passed that period. We are ready to ramp up towards product development stage together with MirrorX.
MirrorX is a young startup company from EPFL, and as we have limited resources in a sense that we need to rely on strategic partners for designing, prototyping and releasing products. We managed to hit the first milestone, which is producing prototypes which were qualifying and it works.
And it seems that a lot of deep tech startups, they appear around, and we are happy that we are collaborating with one of them.
Thin film lithium niobate based photonic integrated circuits will have an impact on scaling up the quantum computing processing power in the next few years. In the same fashion as with, you know, classical computers, you know, you actually had to put all these resources together via network to actually increase the processing power, as we've seen with AI. It will be the same with quantum computers. So those PICs are meant to be the missing link between those quantum computers and also the scale up of the processing power with qubits. So we hope to be able to disrupt that in the very near future. We see this happening in the next 2 to 3 years.
Initially, the target market for thin film lithium niobate seems to be telecom, and in that realm, for example, you can think about the power consumption as data centers. God knows what will happen if we go for quantum computing. You need the components that they consume lower and lower power. At the same time, they are fast.
The medium to long term effects of quantum computing in general to society is countless because of the intractable problems, you know, it could solve. I mean, some of the classical problems that would take you know, hundreds of years could take, you know, minutes or, you know, typically days of computing on quantum computer hardware that is effectively very well connected together via optical networks. So we believe fundamentally that this is going to be a game changer in that area.